and ministers. Ministers, I'll be very short and brief. The decision has been made, and we have to respect the wishes of the people, the majority of the people of this country. And I am a Democrat, and wholeheartedly will accept the wishes of the people. But I think we should be given more time, and this chamber should be given more time, and the whole process should be given more time in regards to debating this legislation. For example, I'm not long here on the start, and I've only sat in very few pre-legislative scrutiny of legislation, probably because the Transport Committee is under the function of Minister Ross, he has actually amended too many bills before the start. But I must say, one of the bills we brought before, came before the start in the past few months, was a bill that had a couple of amendments on it. And by God, before it came into the second stage, it got plenty of discussion by the various interested groups. And I mean, not just one meeting, even through a few meetings. And I would ask the minister, that it's a shame, that he did not go through the process of pre-legislative scrutiny. I don't see why there is a rush job, Mr. I know you'll say that people have waited decades to change this amendment. But in doing so, Minister, I think you should be, we had the 8th Amendment Committee, who sat down before who came out with the recommendation, but they did not have access to the heads of the bill before we went to the country with this referendum. And I'm sure there is a couple of those members who might have different thoughts on the whole legislation, as proved by, we go by the vote of the people, but sometimes we like to play along with exit polls and what comes out of exit polls and what was people's minds. And you do acknowledge, Minister, that, for example, one issue was about the 12 weeks, and that nearly half the people who voted yes in the exit polls, had reservations about the 12-week issue. The decision has been made, but maybe if these things had been discussed more in advance, as I said, the heads of bill should be made more available, and should be discussed more. Look, the decision has been made, and I think David Quinn of the Iona Institute the day after the vote, and he acknowledged we must accept defeat gracefully, but I've been a pro-life, we have to find ways of ensuring that our viewers are still kept out there without breaking the law, and I acknowledge that. But I would ask you, Minister, and maybe as we go into committee stage, that some of the items spoken there by my colleagues in the last few minutes that would be looked at again, and the issue about the conscious issue by our medical administrators, the doctors, the nurses, the midwives, they have concerns, and if they have their beliefs, I don't think we should instruments down that throat, to get this process through. It's ironic, that following the passing of this referendum, that we could find 12 million straight away to put in place what's needed to have abortions in this country. Yes, there's still no mention of care needed for stress, people in stress and pregnancy stress cases. And it's amazing, down 3 years ago, if we had more of this money provided, we might never come to this situation as it is. And, Minister, I said, I'm not going to hug this debate here, but I would ask that the issues, other issues I would mention, would be considered. I would greatly appreciate that, and just saying that I would not be standing in the way, but I would ask that some of the amendments that have been proposed would be given favourable consideration. Thank you, Oireachtas.